According to Tourism Minister and Chairman of the Command Centre, Dominic Fedee, government has taken steps to increase the number of respiratory clinics and quarantine facilities. At one time, according to the minister, government secured 500 hotel rooms for quarantine purposes. Government also enlisted the help of 100 Cuban medical professionals. Mr. Fedee is confident that St. Lucia can win the war against COVID-19. Government, he says, is also moving to get the forensic lab and the lab at the OKEU to expedite the testing process.
In recent times, Mr. Speaker, we've seen that there have been somewhat of a backlog in the testing facility. But we didn't stay here and do nothing. We quickly mobilized the resources, and Mr. Speaker, later on, the forensic lab will be mobilized to join the Owen King EU lab so that we can increase the testing capacity, Mr. Speaker, and make sure that the lines are going a lot faster for people coming through the lines.
The St. Lucia government opened the Owen King EU hospital and converted the Victoria hospital into a respiratory facility to handle COVID-19 cases. Minister Fedee says the enhanced capacity of the Victoria hospital will serve the healthcare system in good stead in the years to come.
And I'm very, very proud of the fact that if you go to Victoria Hospital now, it is the best it has been in the last 20 years. And so, Mr. Speaker, whilst Mr. Speaker, some sarcastically deride us for the improvements we've made at Victoria Hospital, I believe, Mr. Speaker, that for many years to come, our health sector will no doubt benefit from the enhanced capacity of Victoria Hospital.
St. Lucia recorded its first COVID-19 case on March 13th, 2020. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.